Hey guys, congratulations. You have made it to the final week and we're actually already into that week. So, great news. So, we are almost done. Just a few reminders. Remember that if you do not have to take the final exam, then this is your final project. Woohoo! You have made it. That is so exciting for you, I know. And you will be exempt from that exam if you have an 80 or higher as an average of quarter three and quarter four. So I will take your quarter three grade, put it next to your quarter four grade, add them together, then divide them, and we will see what your average is. And it has to be an 80 or higher. Technically, a 79.5 is what we were told. Remember, I will be taking off your lowest minor or major assessment as well. Whichever one helps your grade more. Two classwork grades are already exempted, but I won't exempt the minor major assessment grade until this weekend. Before we get started on using infographics in design, obviously that's what we're talking about. We're actually going to pray though, so let's bow our heads. Dear Jesus, I come before you. I just thank you for these students. I thank you for their hard work, their effort. During this long and trying time, I just pray that you would be with them. Just help them to continue to do well, Lord. Just let them shine for you. Thank you that you love us, that you care for us. I pray that you'd be with each of their individual needs. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Alrighty. So, as we were getting into this week, I was just reminded of Paul, and he went through a lot of hard things in his life. And one of the things he said was, "I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith." And although that verse has a lot of I's in it, Paul was not talking about himself. Paul was not very prideful, and when he boasted, he'd never boasted in himself. He boasted in God and the things that God was doing in his life. And he's basically saying, "I was able to do this. I was able to survive all of this horrible, crazy stuff." We think we're facing craziness. Look at Paul's life, and you will realize that it's nothing, but it is something. But nonetheless, he was saying he was able to do that because God was within him and God helped him through that. So as you're facing this final week, if you are feeling overwhelmed, if you're feeling like you can't do it, just remember that God is with you and that he will help you get through it, and focus on that. And if you're feeling strong and like you've got this, remember that it's not just you, that it's him who has helped you get through this, and be grateful for that. So let's go ahead and talk about infographics. What are infographics? This definition is from the Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary, and it's basically information or data that is shown in a chart or diagram so that it is easy to understand. This is something right up our alley in the world of design because we want our messages to communicate with others. We want them to look at it and to be able to say, "Wow, that looks good, and now I know this information as a result of this." So I'm going to show you a few examples first. A lot of times you'll see infographics for things like health. Sometimes you'll use them just for silly things. Sometimes you'll use them in your classes for things like history. Here are three examples. One is from the World Health Organization, one is just kind of a silly one, and one is from the American Heart Association. So as you can see with these, they have a lot of like just little symbols, they have numbers, but they're graphically presenting a ton of information. So this one is talking about better health for people with deaf disabilities. This is my title. It's up near the top. It's easy to see. There's a bunch of main colors, and it kind of points back to that. Over here, we're talking about the effects of excessive sodium on your health and appearance. So right off the bat, you know what's happening. Here is the year in numbers, 2013. Out of the three of these titles, the one that's the easiest to see is obviously this one. And that's because they have it kind of centered at the top, and it has different colors and different types of fonts, and it is really bold and it stands out. So that one's probably the best. Something I want you to notice with this one is the typography. There's not a lot of different type of fonts going on. You have this nice, easy to read block font, and then occasionally you have this script font that looks like cursive handwriting. It is used very sparingly. Occasionally, our fonts change colors. Sometimes they get bold, sometimes they italicize, but there is not a lot of differentiation. That is a good thing. Same thing here. Your fonts are pretty basic and the same. The only time you step out of your two basic fonts is with this little Metallica, this H&M, Krispy Kreme, and that's because they're logos that belong to it. So our fonts do not have to be crazy. You should only probably use about two of them. You're also going to notice with colors, especially on these two outer ones that were made by well-known organizations, they stick with a basic number of colors. You have blue, orange, white, and black on this. There are a few shades of blue that show up differently, but it is in the same family. So that is four basic colors. Over here, you have this like tealish color, red, black, and white. Black and white are kind of just givens. You also have this little bit of tan that's used. So once again, we're staying nice and basic. When you're doing this, don't do a kaleidoscope of colors. This one has a few more going on, but they still stay within basic families of red, blue, green, and yellow. Then they have the occasional other thing going on. Having these numbers is a little bit better, but you want to look at that. And then they have big numbers that stand for things and big graphics. So the idea is to draw you into them. This one's telling us 9 out of 10 Americans consume too much sodium. So you have 10 people here, and 9 of them are the ones that did too much. Where does it come from? 65% supermarket convenience stores. They got the little shopping cart. 25% restaurants. 10% other sources. So they're pointing to information, but it's not written in paragraph form. It's just little bullets. Occasionally, you'll have something that's a little bit longer, like high blood pressure is a leading risk factor for death in women in the United States. Da, 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 da. That's okay to have that, but everything else is kind of basic and small. That's what you're looking for. So, what design components do we see with this? Well, we see our margins around the outside. This one does a really good job of showing that. You see gutters. They actually map out their gutters with lines on these, and that is okay. You can do that with this, but you can still see the gutters and where things are supposed to be. You see typography, so different types of typography, different type of color. We see lots of images. We see charts. Now, these aren't your traditional charts where it's a pie chart. You can put that on there, but they're things like this. This is an example of a chart in this. Chart. I said that was a funny word. I'm so sorry, guys. A chart in this. Over here, here's another example. 1 in 7 people, they're talking about are disabled. So you have your 7 people and one of them is disabled. So it's kind of helping to visualize that. So how do you make them? You can make them using design software. We would utilize at school, if we were in school, we would utilize either Photoshop or InDesign to work with this. We'd probably work with both of them together. But because you guys do not have that software available, I'm going to suggest you use something called canva.com. It's a free website, and if you search infographics, they have pre-made layouts that you can just go and pop the information into. This is an easy way to do it since we are not at school with our normal thing. So my suggestion would be to use that. If you want to utilize whatever other software is on your iPad or computer, you can do that as well. With Canva, you do have to make an account, but it is free, so it's not anything that's bad. I've used it for things in the past. Oops, sorry guys. All right, so what should yours include? Well, you guys are actually going to do yours on the coronavirus or COVID-19. So these are the things I'm looking for. Number one, what it is. So you're going to define coronavirus. What is this thing? Signs to look out for. So those are signs and symptoms, fever, cough, all those types of things. You need at least 5 of those. This is on the rubric. We'll go over that in a second. Ways to stay safe. We need at least 3 of those. You guys should know this information. What to do if you think you have it. You might not know that, so research it. Current data for Florida and the US. I want to know people infected, people recovered, people killed. This would be a great idea for where you could put in some little charts. And then citations neatly at the bottom. You always need to cite where you get information from. First of all, we have to tell where it's from so that people are getting credit for the work that they've done. And then also, it gives you credibility so people can believe what you're looking at. So, how am I grading you? This rubric is attached to the assignment, but we'll go over it. Overall design, it should be organized, fill the area and complement the project. So I should have all of those little things organized neatly on the thing. We shouldn't have a giant empty space at the top or in the bottom or the middle. It should be filled nicely, and then it should complement the project. You can use your fonts and your colors to utilize this. Excellent. We talked about colors. 2 to 4 colors are used, and they complement one another and the project. Remember, white and black don't necessarily count as a color, but you don't want a rainbow. We want to use just differing shades, and we want to keep it simple. Graphics, at least 3 graphics are added, and they are professional in appearance and support the topic. So for these graphics, they're basic things. They're not pictures of you and me. They're little shapes of men and people. When you go on Canva.com, they have all those there. It's easy to use. Spelling and grammar, obviously, we're always looking at that. When we are in the area of design, we always want to make sure that whatever we design looks professional. Part of that is spelling and grammar. Definition, it should be clearly defined, easy to see. So your colors, the size, the font you have, it should be easy to see, and then easy to understand. Signs to look out for: at least 5 symptoms are listed in an easy to see and understand manner. This should not be written out in paragraph form. If you have COVID-19, you will be likely to experience chills, comma, you know, whatever that is. Instead, it should probably be bulleted. That's a great area to just have it listed. Ways to stay safe: at least 3 ways to stay safe are listed and easy to see and understand manner. So same thing as before. What to do if you think you have it? It should be clearly defined, easy to see, easy to understand. You guys see a pattern? Should. Current data for Florida: people infected, recovered, and killed is clearly defined, easy to see, and easy to understand. Data for the US is the same thing. And then citations, they should be neatly listed at the bottom in a small yet easy to read text. If they are on the page but either too big or distracting from the project, like you got them in a bright color, let's just do a nice simple black at the bottom, you'll lose points. If they're missing, you'll obviously lose points again. So I hope you guys have fun with this. Do your best to research. You'll have 2 days to get this in. And if you have any questions, please message me on the portal. If not, good luck, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Know that I love you, and I'm praying for you, and I'm here for you if you need anything. Bye.